Why do I need another email address to access my account? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I can't log into my account as it keeps saying it wants another email to use as recovery. I do not have one. Do I have to get another account from somewhere in order to use it now? If so, I'll start using the new one and get rid of this one. What an inconvenience in that I have no access to my own account. So no, this is not some conspiracy to get you to create yet another email address. Heck, the email address doesn't even have to technically be yours, but it does have to be set up before you need it. And to be clear, it is incredibly important to both set it up and keep it up to date. Someday in the future, you'll really wish you had, should you ever have problems signing into your account. Recovery or alternate email addresses are nothing new, and they're certainly not limited to any one provider. Almost all the free email services allow you to set one up. In fact, it's strongly recommended that you do. They're used if you ever lose access to the account. For example, let's say you've lost your password and you can't log in. You then click the I forgot my password link, or whatever it's called for the service you're using, and it then sends a password link to the recovery email address. The assumption, of course, is that you have access to that recovery email account, and by virtue of having access to the recovery email account that you previously configured, you must be authorized, you must be the right person to be able to get access to the account. Once you get that link, you click on it, you change your password on your primary email account, and you log in again. I can't stress this enough. The recovery email address is something you must set up before you need it. Obviously, if you could just set one up without logging in, well, then hackers could use that to hack into arbitrary accounts. So that's just a non-starter. You must configure in your account settings a recovery email address before you need it. Typically, it's another email account, ideally at another email service that you have access to. Now, it's also important to point out that it doesn't help to set up a recovery email address that doesn't work. I've seen people type in bogus email addresses as their recovery address. I've also seen people let the recovery email account simply expire due to lack of use and get closed. If you ever lose access to your primary account for any number of reasons, you're going to need that recovery address to work. At that point, it's too late to change it or to set it up. If it's configured, but it doesn't work, it's like not having set it up at all. You may not get access to your account. So, typically, the right thing to do is to set up a recovery address at another service. For example, set up a Yahoo account to be the recovery address for your Gmail or Outlook.com account, that kind of thing. Then set up it the other way too. Set the Gmail address to be the recovery address for the Yahoo account. And then make sure you log into the recovery account from time to time so that it never gets closed for inactivity. Now, you can also use the email address of a very trusted friend as your recovery email address. I say very trusted because, of course, since they have the recovery address, they could hijack your account very quickly and very easily, and there would be no going back. You wouldn't even have legal recourse since you gave them access. I've seen too many relationships and friendships go bad to ever recommend this, but I do have to throw it out as one strong possibility. Finally, it's just possible that some systems are strongly recommending or perhaps even insisting that you create a recovery email address. Just do it. What the systems are responding to is the incredible number of account hacks that happen every day. If someone has a recovery email address set up and working, then they're able to regain access to their accounts relatively quickly and easily. If they don't, well, then when their account gets hacked, it could just as easily be gone forever. There's no evil intent here. The services really are just trying to protect you. So, bottom line, set up your recovery email address. Set up a recovery phone number if that's available. And above all, keep them up to date. I see many accounts lost forever because the recovery information was no longer valid. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/14420. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.